chamber. The parliament itself do have a photographer and we have our cameras, so if you wish to see the official photography from the day, it will be on our website, our Facebook feed, our Twitter feed, our Instagram feed, and on YouTube, so hopefully you'll be able to see images from the day there. When the fanfare has sounded, I'd ask that you all please stand. And finally, and hopefully most importantly, we hope you enjoy the day.
Inwards.
Thank you.
Your Majesty, Your Royal Highness, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of my fellow MSPs, can I welcome you and thank you for joining us at the opening of this, the fifth session of the Scottish Parliament. Ciad míle faoilte go Parlamáid na hÁlba. A particularly warm welcome to you, Your Majesty, and not just because of the significant milestones you have achieved this year. Your presence here today and the support you have given Parliament from the beginning of devolution has helped this institution develop the authority it now enjoys. And I know that many people across this country have enjoyed celebrating with you a remarkable year. On your most recent official visit to Scotland, you became our longest reigning monarch. I was privileged to represent the Parliament last month at St. Paul's on the occasion of your 90th birthday celebrations, the same day as the 95th celebrations of Your Royal Highness, Duke of Edinburgh. And it was an enjoyable occasion, made all the more delightful, I may add, when our First Minister, Nicola Sturgeon, introduced our Secretary of State, David Mundell, to your guests as her husband. Inadvertently, I may add, as the two had swapped places, but as David Mundell himself observed, we did not need a referendum to know that was one union doomed to disappointment from the start. Your Majesty, over 9 decades, you have witnessed so much. Extraordinary social and economic change, phenomenal scientific and technological advances, disturbing and ever-increasing environmental anxiety. But critically, you have seen successive generations rise to the challenges that lie before them. Your Majesty, the Parliament before you today stands ready for the challenges that lie ahead of us. Every MSP in this chamber is proud to represent the people of Scotland. We have been given the opportunity to serve and to contribute in a Parliament which has been refreshed. 2 out of every 5 MSPs here has been elected for the first time, rejuvenating our democracy, reminding us of the promise of devolution to work together across party lines for the good of all. In these few short weeks, weeks of unprecedented political turbulence, I've already seen a real willingness to work together cooperatively and collaboratively. I've seen the emergence of a shared agenda to clarify the identity and the role of this Parliament, a shared recognition that it is more important than ever that this Parliament finds its voice, a voice for hope, to echo Donald Dewar, a voice for the future. And I say more important than ever because these last few weeks have also borne witness to the politics of hate. Today, outside this Parliament, we fly the rainbow flag of pride, testimony to the 49 lives lost in the senseless shootings in an Orlando nightclub. A flag which displays our solidarity with the families and the communities they left behind. We continue to mourn the loss of our parliamentary colleague, Joe Cox, and I believe it is simply not good enough to condemn such atrocities. We have been given the privilege of public office and we need to lead by example. Just this week, President Michael D. Higgins of Ireland spoke to this chamber and he warned us against the growth of a temporary inchoate populism. And he urged us not to react in kind, but to respond with an open, informed, tolerant and engaged discourse. It was one of the most erudite and powerful arguments for empathy, for the importance of political sympathy I've ever had the privilege to hear. Yes, our exchanges in this Parliament should be passionate and robust, but they should also be respectful. Courtesy, compassion, and gentleness are signs of strength, not of weakness, a lesson many of us could learn from the example of Your Majesty. When this building was first constructed, Edwin Morgan described the open and adventurous Parliament Scotland wanted to see in his poem, Open the Doors, and he implored us not to let our hope be other than great. I have never given up hope, that we can recapture the new kind of politics from which this Parliament was born. But it takes determination to move away from the trench warfare of party lines. It takes real purpose if we are to soften the new binary divisions, yes or no, leave or remain. We need to remember and act on the principles on which we were founded, accessible, transparent in our proceedings, sharing power. And it cannot, must not be simply today that the Parliament opens its doors to the people of Scotland. Last Friday morning, we all awoke to the monumental impact of the EU referendum result, an event which has already had a profound and dramatic impact on the political landscape. But I will also remember that date as my daughter Annie's last day at primary school. And as she moves on to high school, I want all our children not to be filled with anxiety. I want her to grow up full of expectation and excitement, secure in the knowledge that we are shaping a positive future for them. I want them to study and learn, to work and to prosper, to play, to laugh, to fall in love, in a world in which our humanity can live up to the deepest meaning of the word. Your Majesty, amidst some of the bad news over the last month, there was at least one little moment of joy when your horse, Dartmouth, won at Royal Ascot. We shared your undisguised pleasure on our TV screens. And politics is a little like horse racing in that it can often strike people as the triumph of hope over experience. But despite the public cynicism, in my experience, most politicians are incurable optimists. And 17 years ago, almost to this day, I took my place. I was filled with hope as I took my place in the first Scottish Parliament. And as I stand here again today, I can feel that fire rekindled in my heart. We stand at the brink of a new session with all the hope and promise that can bring. We have 5 years to make a difference, 5 years to make Scotland a fairer, kinder, and more prosperous country, 5 years to build a better place for us all to live. Government or opposition, front or back bench, each one of us has something to contribute. For as Jo Cox said in her maiden speech in the Commons, we have far more in common than that which divides us. My hope, like the poet's, is still great. Your Majesty, can I call on you to address this meeting of Parliament?
Presiding Officer, First Minister, members of the Scottish Parliament, it is a pleasure to be invited to address you on this special occasion to mark the opening of the fifth session of the Scottish Parliament. I would like to begin by thanking you, Presiding Officer, for your kind words of welcome and extending my good wishes to you in your new role. You carry a heavy responsibility for protecting the reputation and good conduct of this Parliament. And I have no doubt that you will follow in the steps of your predecessors in demonstrating fairness, good judgment, and impartiality, as well as being a strong advocate of the Parliament. Members of the Scottish Parliament, occasions such as today are rightly a time for hope and optimism. The beginning of this new session in particular brings with it a real sense of renewal, with your largest intake of new members since 1999. For me, it also brings an echo of the excitement and enthusiasm I encountered that year, when many of the then MSPs, and I'm pleased to note that quite a number of you are still serving today, set out on a collective journey in Scottish public service. 17 years on, the Scottish Parliament has grown in maturity and skill. Of course, we all live and work in an increasingly complex and demanding world, where events and developments can and do take place at remarkable speed. And retaining the ability to stay calm and collected can at times be hard. As this Parliament has successfully demonstrated over the years, one hallmark of leadership in such a fast-moving world is allowing sufficient room for quiet thinking and contemplation, which can enable deeper, cooler consideration of how challenges and opportunities can be best addressed. I'm sure also you will continue to draw inspiration from the founding principles of the Parliament and the key values of wisdom, justice, compassion, and integrity that are engraved on the mace. These principles and values have already served the Scottish Parliament well, and they will continue to guide new and returning members in the years ahead. During this session, the Parliament will implement significant new tax and welfare powers, in addition to other areas of public policy. I wish you every success as you prepare to take on these extra responsibilities. And I remain confident that you will use the powers at your disposal wisely and continue to serve the interests of all the people of Scotland to the best of your ability. As well as formally marking the opening of the fifth session of the Scottish Parliament, today is also a day where people will come together in Edinburgh to celebrate excellence in Scotland. And I can say without fear of contradiction that there is certainly a lot to celebrate. Today we are reminded of Edwin Morgan's poem, Open the Doors, and I understand that this afternoon's activities are themed around that poem, which famously has the line, "We have a building that is more than a building." What a wonderful way of describing this Parliament. Presiding Officer, First Minister, members of the Scottish Parliament, the Duke of Edinburgh and I will continue to follow your progress with the closest of interest, and we extend to you all our warmest good wishes as you embark on this fifth session of Parliament.
Thank you. Open the doors. Fos glavna dorsin. Open the doors. Light of the day, shine in. Light of the mind, shine out. We have a building which is more than a building. There is a commerce between inner and outer, between brightness and shadow, between the world and those who think about the world.
Is it not a mystery? The parts cohere, they come together like petals of a flower. Yet they also send their tongues outwards to feel and taste the teeming earth. Did you want classic columns and predictable pediments? A growl of old Gothic grandeur? A blissfully boring box?
Not here. No thanks. No icon, no IKEA, no iceberg. But curves and caverns, nooks and niches, huddles and heaven syncopations and surprises. Leave symmetry to the cemetery.
But bring together slate and stainless steel, black granite and grey granite, seasoned oak and sycamore, concrete blonde and smooth as silk. The mix is almost alive. It breathes and beckons. Imperial marble it is not.
Come down the mile into the heart of the city, past the Kirk of St. Giles and the closes and wines of the noted ghost of history, who drank their claret and fell down the steep tenement stairs into the arms of link boys, but who wrote and talked the starry enlightenment of their days.
And before them, the old mackers who tickled a Scottish king's ear with melody, ribaldry, and frank advice. And when you are there, down there in the midst of things, not set upon an hill with your nose in the air, this is where you know your parliament should be, and this is where it is, just here.
What do the people want of the place? They want it to be filled with thinking persons as open and adventurous as its architecture. A nest of theories is what they do not want. A symposium of procrastinators is what they do not want. A phalanx of forelock tuggers is what they do not want. And perhaps, above all, the droopy mantra of it wasnae me is what they do not want.
Dear friends, dear lawgivers, dear parliamentarians, you are picking up a thread of pride and self-esteem that has been almost, but not quite, oh no, not quite, not ever broken or forgotten.
When you convene, you will be reconvening with a sense of not wholly the power, not yet wholly the power, but a good sense of what was once in the honour of your grasp. All right, forget or don't forget the past. Trumpets and robes are fine, but in the present and the future, you will need something more.
What is it? We, the people, cannot tell you yet, but you will know about it when we do tell you. We give you our consent to govern. Don't pocket it and ride away. We give you our deepest, dearest wish to govern well. Don't say we have no mandate to be so bold. We give you this great building. Don't let your work and hope be other than great when you enter and begin.
So now begin. Fos glavna dorsin. Open the doors and begin.
Threshold. Let's blether some more about doors
revolving doors and sliding doors, half opened, half closed. The door with your name on it, the heavy one, hard to open. The one you walked out when your heart was broken. The one you walked in as you came to your profession. And the tiny door when you made your confession. The school door at the end of a lesson. Yes, shut the door in Gaelic is Dún an Doras. The wee door on your doll's house, or Ibsen's Nora's door, or Chekhov's Three Sisters. Doors imagined by writers the world over. Proust and the chickens coming home to roost. Or Chris Guthrie's open heart at the end of Sunset Song. Or the step left when the horse is gone, the haw, the door to the stable bolted after the horse left. Not Tam O'Shanter's tailless horse, the one that shut violently behind you, banged by a sudden wind. The painted red door, code for asylum seeker. The X that says plague or Passover. The one turned into a boat to cross the ever-widening waters. The North Sea and the Aegean, reminders of the people cleared off their lands, out their crofts, to whom the sea was their threshold, on, off. Take the big key and open the door to the living, breathing past, the one you enliven over and over, to the ship's port, the house of the welder, to the library door of Donald Dewar. Then picture yourself on the threshold, the exact moment when you might begin again. A new sitting, new keys, jingle possibilities. Hope comes with a tiny Greyfriars Bobby keyring. Then come through to this parliament, new session, pass round the revolving doors, change in the revolutions, 360 degrees. Take in the mirrored opposites, the Dutch gables, the cross gables. Here, rising out of the sloping base of Arthur's Seat, straight into a city that must also speak for the Banks and the Braes, Munros, Cairns, Bothies, songs, art, poems, art, stories. And don't forget the Cayleys. Who doesn't he love a Cayley? Hoo! A city that remembers the fiddlers of Orkney and Shetland, the folk of Colonsay, Bute and Tyree, the inner and outer Hebrides, the glens and the bens, the trees and the rivers and the burns and the lochs and the sea lochs, and Nessie, the granite city, Dumfries and Galloway, the dear green place and Dundee. Across the stars and galaxy, the night sky's tiny keys, the Hail Clan Jamfery. Find here what you are looking for, democracy in its infancy. Guard her like you would a small daughter, and keep the door not just wide out, not keep the door wide open, not just ajar, and say in any language you please, welcome, welcome to the world's refugees. Scotland's changing faces, look at me, whose birth mother walked through the door of a mother and baby home here and walked out of Elsie Ingalls Hospital without me, my macker, her daughter, macker of fairly led and gallus tongues. And this is my country, says the fisherwoman from Jura. Mine too, says the child from Cana and Iona. Mine too, says the Brain family. And mine, says the man from the Polish deli. And mine, said the brave and beautiful Acid Shah. Me too, said the Black Scot and the Red Scot, said William Wallace and Mary Queen of Scots, said both the Roberts and Muriel Spark, said Emily Sandy and Arthur Wharton, said Ali Smith and Edwin Morgan, said Liz Lochhead, Norman and Sorley, and mine, said the Syrian refugee. Here we are, in this building of pure poetry, on this July morning, in front of Her Majesty. Good day, ma'am. Ma'am, good day. Good morning, Helen and John Kay. Great believers in democracy and in geeing it loudy. Our strength is our difference. Dinny fear it, dinny caw canny. It takes more than one language to tell a story.
Habarachka er unshanan ayigu skalachka insha.
Welcome.
Fun ying.
One language is never enough.
Beblor dekasese, menyo tututuo.
Welcome.
Vitame.
It takes more than one language to tell a story.
Eka kahani sunani kelie. Ekase adika bashayain lagati hang.
Welcome.
Gianu.
One language is never enough.
Un long ne suffit jamais.
Welcome.
Falcha.
It takes more than one tongue to tell a story.
It takes mair than a right tongue to clip a story.
Welcome.
Marhaba.
Welcome.
Inur.
Welcome.
Willkommen.
Welcome.
Benvenuti.
It takes more than one language to tell a story.
Kahani batani kelie. Exe ziada zaban leta he.
Welcome.
Welcome. Welcome. Falcha.
Come bend the living room. Come join our brilliant gathering.
Your Majesty, Your Royal Highness, Presiding Officer, fellow members of Parliament, distinguished guests, today is a day to celebrate our strength, our ambition, and our unity. This is a day to come together, a day to look forward with hope. Your Majesty, first and foremost, we want to thank you most sincerely for affording us the honour of opening the fifth session of our Parliament and for your thoughtful address to us this morning. And since this is not yet December, I trust that birthday wishes are still in order. So on behalf of everyone in this chamber, indeed on behalf of all of the people of Scotland, I would like to wish Your Majesty a very happy 90th birthday year. Your Majesty, your lifetime of service to others, to your country and the Commonwealth, your deep sense of duty, dignity and respect, and your firm and constant support and affection for Scotland are an inspiration to all of us, and we thank you for it. Today marks the formal opening of this, the fifth term of our National Parliament. All of us elected to this magnificent chamber feel a deep sense of honour in the trust that the people of Scotland have placed in us. We come from a diverse variety of backgrounds, but all of us have been given the precious opportunity to contribute to building a better country, and build it we will. To do so, we must be bold and ambitious. We must show courage and determination. Our collective commitment to the people of Scotland today is that we will not shy away from any challenge we face, no matter how difficult or deep-rooted. We must seek to extend opportunity for everyone at every stage of their lives. And as parliamentarians, we must always remember our duty to lead by example, with open, honest, and good-spirited debate and discussion. Our duty to be a voice for all of the people of our country. When Scotland's first minister, the late Donald Dewar, addressed this Parliament at its opening 17 years ago, he delivered then one of the finest speeches of our times. He said that a Scottish Parliament is about more than our politics and our laws. This is about who we are, how we carry ourselves. So allow me to reflect on who we are
in Scotland today. We are more than 5 million men and women, adults, young people and children, each with our own life stories, family histories and our own hopes and dreams. We are the grandchildren and the great-grandchildren of the thousands who came from Ireland to work in our shipyards and in our factories. We are the 80,000 Polish people, the 8,000 Lithuanians, the 7,000 each from France, Spain, Germany, Italy and Latvia, who are among the many from countries beyond our shores that we are so privileged to have living here amongst us. We are the more than 500,000 people born in England, Wales and Northern Ireland who have chosen to live here in Scotland. We are the thousands of European students studying at our universities and our colleges. And we are the doctors and nurses from all across our continent and beyond who care for us daily in our National Health Service. Whether we have lived here for generations or are new Scots from Europe, India, Pakistan, Africa, and countries across the globe, we are all of this and more. We are so much stronger for the diversity that shapes us. We are one Scotland, and we are simply home to all those who have chosen to live here. That is who and what we are. And how do we carry ourselves? We carry ourselves with dignity. We treat others with respect. We celebrate our differences. We are not perfect, far from it, and we do make mistakes. But every day, especially in adversity or sadness, we should seek to offer a hand to our neighbour. A few weeks ago, all of Scotland, including leaders from across this chamber, stood in solidarity with the victims of the Orlando massacre. And today we fly the rainbow flag outside our parliament. We do so with poignancy, but also with great pride. It is yet another vivid illustration and powerful symbol of the open and inclusive nation that we are. The open and inclusive nation that we are determined to remain. This is the Scotland we represent, a country we should never take for granted, but instead work hard each and every day to protect and to strengthen. This Parliament now has the weighty responsibility of taking forward the will of our people in the name and in the spirit of our people. So let us lead with hope and determination and make this resolution. We will work every day to achieve greater equality at home and to enhance and never diminish our precious place in the world. We have just heard the inspiring words of our wonderful new macker, Jackie Kaye. Let me now finish with the words of her predecessor, Liz Lochhead. These words are from Connecting Cultures, a poem written by Liz to celebrate Commonwealth Day. These words resonate powerfully as we think about who we are and as we reflect on our place in the European Union and in the wider world. Remembering how hard fellow feeling is to summon when wealth is what we do not have in common. May every individual and all the peoples in each nation work and hope and strive for true communication. Only by a shift in sharing is there any chance for the welfare of all our people and good governance. So, Presiding Officer, today as we celebrate this new beginning, let us look forward with hope and a shared determination to work tirelessly for the good of all of Scotland's people, and in doing so, to play our part in a stronger Europe and a better world.
Is there for honest poverty that hangs his head and all that? The coward slave we pass him by, we dare be true or all that. For all that and all that, our toils obscure and all that. The rank is but the guinea stamp, the man's a gout for all that. What though unnamely fair we dine, where hodden grey and all that? Gie fools their silks and knaves their wine, a man's a man for all that. For all that and all that, their tinsels show and all that. The honest man, the wealthy poor, is king o' man for all that. You see yon birkie called a lord, what struts and stares and all that. Though hundreds worship at his word, he's but a coof for all that. For all that and all that, his ribbon star and all that. The man who independent mind, he looks and laughs at all that. A prince can mak a belted knight, a marquis, duke and all that. But an honest man's upon his might, good faith he manna for that. For all that and all that, their dignities and all that, the pith of sense and pride of worth are higher ranks than all that. Then let us pray that come a day, and soon it will, for all that, that sense and worth o'er all the earth shall bear the gree and all that. For all that and all that, it's coming yet for all that. That man to man the world o'er shall brothers be for all that.
I now close this session of the Scottish Parliament.